map rotations.
Yeah, I agree.
It is even more important now. And there's LS.
Yep.
Didn't talk about him yesterday, but LS, the coach for Gravity, new coach coming in, flying in from Korea. He'll be doing that every 2 weeks.
That'll be a fun one to deal with, but we'll see if Gravity can craft themselves a good team composition with some extra tutelage. These guys have been having a pretty rough time actually finding good coaching staff, so see if that works here for Gravity. Meanwhile, Maokai, Jarvan, Kassadin all removed from these guys. Ahri, Rumble, Lissandra banned away, and Impulse, they're going to first pick Morgana.
The Morgana for Adrian. I have seen some Morgana mid and Morgana top. We'll have to see what happens there. It's kind of a flex pick for all intents and purposes, but we'll see where it goes. I do want to talk about LS a little more, though, because when you pick up a coach on Gravity's side, and St. Vicious has a good say in that, a good chunk of the say, it has to be somebody that he respects. And he's a big veteran of the scene, ton of knowledge. When he is kind of seeding things over and saying, all right, this guy knows his stuff, this guy's going to be able to teach me things, that's a really good sign of a coach that can actually, and now an analyst, there you go, that can improve the team. Analyst, yay.
Analyst?
Yeah, I know, that's the word I want.
Okay.
But you start one and then you change it over mid, doesn't work out.
I know exactly how that works.
The analyst.
It's like sharpening crayons with ships in the night. It's a mixed metaphor. It's very strange. It doesn't even matter. Gravity, though, Kopp is going to get his most comfortable of AD carries in Corki. And for whatever reason, a big resurgence of Braum this week is going to get picked up by Bunny Fufu.
Seems to be when people go for your back line, you want the Braum, but Braum's also a fantastic level one champion if they want to bring it out. But I actually absolutely love Braum. There's so many skill shots in the game now that it really just stops those and dead in their tracks. You know, Yasuo, the days of him are long gone in competitive play.
Not for Shao Wei Shao.
Not for Shao Wei Shao, but so wind wall mechanics and things alike, like it, similar to it, pretty much only exist with Braum. And he's been a very good support for a very long time. He just hasn't seen a lot of play, mainly because Janna's been around for a bit. People have been locking in the Janna, and Braum isn't the best support against that.
It's weird because I feel like Braum also works in a lot of comps that Janna works in, but he sometimes just does it better. He's actually better at keeping people alive when you are trying to dive the back line, but we'll see if that ends up being the comp here for Gravity. Corki, pretty self-sufficient just the same. Rush will get Rek'Sai. And Sivir in for Apollo means a great teamfighting comp already.
Run you down, allow them to keep the distance close. And the big thing here is if you get hit by a Dark Binding, regardless of whether or not you use your Unbreakable on it, you're going to eat that Boomerang Blade right afterward. That's a ton of damage. If it hits onto Kopp, it chunks him out very quickly. And if they lane swap and it's on the solo laner, he pretty much has to back at that point.
So, time to be afraid then if your Gravity. Long range bindings have been winning teams games so far in the North American LCS, especially when there's follow-up to make sure the kill actually comes through. Gravity now seeing what they expect to maybe be the bot lane, but otherwise a whole lot of flex picks. They can't really pin down this team Impulse comp. Have to pick two more members here. Their jungler and a solo laner. Likely to come in here for Gravity. And heck, just put Keen on Zed again. Why the heck not?
He's currently undefeated on Zed. He has two wins on that champion, going 7-2-10 and 7-1-6. And St. Vicious also had a victory yesterday on Nunu. So Nunu synergizing with this team composition, it's kind of weird. They create a lot of zones, a lot of slows here, but ultimately it's a poke you down, disengage, and then have Kopp or have Keen split push and join the fight to blow somebody up.
Yeah.
It's a weird kind of disengage, split push, engage. Like this is really good if you want to have one person split push, and then the rest can disengage the 4-on-5 if they go with that route.
Yeah, well, looks like they're going to go for more engage power, though it will be a solo lane Morgana, by the way, as Janna support comes in. But so many ways to run into you with Black Shield and Sivir ulti coming in here. Lulu for support. It is a low damage team. Impulse relying heavily on Apollo for the damage output on Sivir. But my god, can they team fight at you pretty hard.
Protect the Sivir comp. Okay.
They took a page out of Gravity's book from yesterday.
Yeah, Gravity ran a composition just like that. But Kopp had an outstanding performance on that Sivir. So we're going to have to see if Apollo can hold toe-to-toe with that. They do need this Sivir to not be shut down, though, because then it's primarily magic damage on this composition. It's very easy to itemize against.
True.
And kind of bursty magic damage. It's not going to be very sustained, very pump out over time. It's... Oh, man.
Yeah.
Yep, that's the person you pick against the double AP.
Exactly. When you don't have enough sustained damage to kill people off, who do you pick but a tank that sits around for a long time and keeps belting out damage? Gravity, multiple threats in the team comp. Overstepping does put you in the way of Zed, but Mundo, to hold the front line, puts this team comp together. A bunch of tanks and a Corki in the back line.
A lot of people who can disengage a fight whilst Keen split pushes. A lot of people who can stall and buy time and make sure you don't die. And you're probably not going to die to this TIP comp anyway. You would have to get caught out by a binding, but that's really their only trick here. To hard engage on you. Really, that's it. Like, Rush could get in there,
yeah,
but then he's at risk. He's going to get slowed, stunned up, and a Rek'Sai that doesn't close the gap initially is miserable.
Sure. And you, I mean, maybe what, like, Lulu and Sivir can help you get in if you miss it in the first place. Like, maybe that's a chance here.
It's still really rough. You want that knock-up. You want that extra auto attack on them afterwards.
Oh, sure. I completely agree with you here. So Team Impulse looking to run around the map pretty quickly and find these skirmishes when the fight does break out. They hope Mundo's not too big. Gravity, meanwhile, a lot of different ways to play around this map. They've got a dedicated split pusher once again in Keen. That man is undefeated on Zed, and maybe he'll do well with that champion once again. Top on a comfort champion. I mean, Corki's going to put out good damage kind of regardless.
Yeah.
So we'll see how they transition the game.
When we did see Keen playing Zed over in Oceania, he was always the split pusher. His Orianna was really good at knowing the time to roam. So I want to see how much he moves around the map this game.
We'll see if they can do it for you guys at home. Tell us who you think is going to win this match. Send hashtag TIPWin or hashtag GVWin to at LOL Esports. Gravity had the chance to keep up with Cloud9. They put themselves continually into a tie for third place. This time Winterfog couldn't be part of it. Team Impulse, though, with a loss, I believe, would sink down to where Dignitas and Team 8 sit.
Around that part, near the bottom. Mm-hmm. Nobody wants him to be even close to the bottom right now. There's a bunch of lava right there. The bottom is lava. And place is lava. You just can't touch it.
Here we go.
Want to keep eyes on Xiaowei Xiao, though. He was the one to watch coming into this week. And up against Keen, who loves to roam. I want to see the type of pressure that he can exert here. But Gravity, five-man invade, four-man invade, actually. Keen's off on the side.
That sweeper will not die. They trade vision, and Apollo knows that they know that he knows.
Why don't you? And I know that you know. But having a Braum is a very good level one. We saw it with CLG. So you almost have no fears. You just walk straight up, waltz into their jungle, completely just you disregard anything they could possibly do to you when you're grouped as four or five.
Mm-hmm. Unless you're facing Dignitas.
Yeah.
And they just jump on you anyway. And Rush, yeah, he started with a sweeper, and he did find the early ward.
Wow. I like that adaptation there. You deny the knowledge of the lane swap. I wonder if we'll be seeing more of that. I love these little tiny adjustments. Mm-hmm. Like Minions when Dignitas spawned. Just hid in the wolf camp. Great idea, except not against the team that has a great level one like that.
Yeah.
Right? Like, it's a very good idea because you know they want to get that deep ward. This, starting with the sweeper and making sure they don't know where your lanes are going, brilliant. Very tiny thing, but it works out.
So yeah, no vision whatsoever. They can spot the jungle path, but all they know is Rek'Sai started topside. They will not know where the Impulse duo is for a while. And Adrian wants to muck up the early jungle pathing. Haunter and Saint Vicious. Saint has not burned Smite. Should be a pretty clean take. Grab. They gotta be careful though. Ice Blast and Cleavers is maybe more than Adrian wanted. Forced to flash early, but Gravity can chase. There's a Cleaver again. In comes Sivir, but it's not gonna be enough. I can't imagine Adrian living here. Burns the exhaust, a bit of damage on Saint, and no, they do disengage it.
At the cost of three summoner spells. No, two. Two summoner spells there. Three counting the smite. From Saint.
Sure, why not? Hey, he hit it.
Boom.
To be fair,
boom.
Gravity.
No, it's two. It's Adrian. He ran up with his exhaust. Just. That's really bad, though. But it's not as bad because they're in a two-on-one.
What's interesting, though, was Impact, by the way, shared the blue buff with Rush. He got, I don't know if he intended to, but he certainly got the kill on the blue. And he can use that to shove the wave out, maybe get some CS, and keep the turret from being pressured. The question is, does Gravity want to shove, or do they want to freeze?
I actually like that.
Rush stays on the bottom side of the map.
I like that a lot, because Rek'Sai is not blue-dependent at all, by any means. Very easy champion to just donate your blue. When I play Rek'Sai, I don't even do my blue until, like, 5 minutes. Because you gank mid first, and you do 5 pressure. You just leave it up for as long as you want.
Mm-hmm.
But giving it over to Impact is a very smooth move there. Because now he's going to be able to survive and just constantly throw out spells, not having to worry about his mana.
Well, and we'll see what other cool plays can happen because of the lane swap situation. Not only was Impact given a blue buff, but an early aggressive pink ward came in from Adrian. that is unlikely to be spotted for a while by Gravage, but will track Nunu's movements around the map. Good dodge on the bind and impact. 13 CS in this lane swap, keeping up with the 80 carries.
Yeah, and the blue buff is definitely helping him in that regard. Haunter, though, he got a pretty good early game getting both summoners from Adrian. But like I said, it's not as big because there isn't constant pressure on your support in a two-on-one. I would be surprised if anything happened to Adrian before his flash and exhaust were back up. They can't capitalize on that.
Now, Muno's not a good gank follow-up, and Nunu's not a good ganker in the first place. So the aggression by Adrian ended up being pretty well measured. I assume he expected that he could survive and did so. St. Vicious, though, level 4, continuing to jungle on his strong side of the map, where his dual lane is.
They saw Rush go into the jungle.
Oh, dear.
They saw him walk up here. Saint was hungry for the Gromp, but now he's hungry for some Void. Some Void Beast. Tracking him down, Braum is running back and forth.
Oh, Rush so far feels safe. Vision enough to get away. Bunny Fufu does get spot on this one. Takes a little bit of damage. And looks like it's going to force them away as the rest of his team really not here to defend. So Rush chunks Bunny to half HP.
Yep, Saint went around the long way just to get to his Krugs.
And look how well Impact's doing. 27, 28 minion kills here. He's actually tied with Kopp in the 1v2. Meanwhile, only 14 minions for Haunter. Not a great mark here. And so far, the lane swap game going quite well for Team Impulse, despite being really fresh as a team.
Yeah, and Impact is never going to suffer from mana for the first couple of minutes here. I think that's, honestly, just giving the blue over really big for this lane swap. The experience, the fact that he doesn't have to back off continually. Like, Morgana's passive gives her the vamp. So she just keeps throwing down Tormented Soils, shoving the wave, and she doesn't have to take anything for it. She doesn't have to apologize for it or play further back.
You know, there's so many other cool things that happen because of the Morgana pick. So Nunu and Braum, all their CCs are incredibly well telegraphed. None of them are immediate as well. Like, they all require some kind of build-up. So Black Shield is, like, completely free at stopping any gank pressure. Like, normally, a top laner like that will get ganked and die, but not in this lineup.
And the fact that it is a solo lane Morgana, she's going to have more AP than the support, so it's a harder Black Shield to break. But he will max it last.
So Rush throws the ward around. Grabs the pink. Oh, he used the sweeper, not realizing it was a pink ward that he spotted. Bit unnecessary there.
Just really didn't like that ward, but he was also spotted by a normal one at the same time.
And first back for St. Vicious gives him a Sight Stone, so he's actually got plenty of vision control. And actually, wow, he finds the pink that Adrian put down just 2 to 3 minutes ago. And that's a really unfortunate loss. But by the way, there's a Mundo
level 5
on this
great
side.
Great time to gank him.
Good knock up by Rush. They're just going to push him off of turret XP by a lot. That's more money that Haunter is not getting here. Down 17 minions against Impact here. The top laner well set up to...
That's a lot of cleavers. Be taking a lot of damage there. Rush has to back off of this Saint coming to reinforce. And now Haunter, he can stay here for a little bit longer. Saint's off on the side. Saint is able to come up to this lane. The turret's going to have the wave crash against it, but still not enough HP in it to make it worthwhile.
No, not quite enough pressure, but Haunter still is losing health. He has teleport, and he's got time to recall. I would expect for... it's actually not going to be enough money for Cowl. But he's going to buy the components for it all the same, and a couple consumables to keep himself safe. So, of course, wants the early spirit visit. He is facing a double AP comp, so...
They swap him. They immediately swap him back as soon as that happens. You get your Sheen on your Corki, you get that one item, you swap him back, you make sure you get the lane matchup.
So we'll see then if Team Impulse is able to match that. Xiaowei Xiao actually starting to have a pretty bad time against Keen. The ulti and Deathmark are up. Xiaowei Xiao, low on mana, actually is at risk of getting bursted. You see he brought Rush over to defend him, as Xiaowei Xiao is looking to not recall, but maybe go for a blue buff.
Looks like Xiaowei Xiao is recalling, and then Rush says, oh, never mind.
Yeah.
You don't want it as a jungler ever. Or at least as Rek'Sai. Just hand it off every time. Looks like a bit of a miscommunication there initially, but they figured it out.
Okay, so Team Impulse, the team with three languages, they said, you know, they're not going to really try to use complex sentences to tell each other what's going on. Smart pings seem to be enough for these guys. And there they go for the blue buff start.
And Impact going straight for the Mirella Nomicon standard build, but it's actually very effective against Mundo on top of everything. But the fact is, they have to get Mundo below 50 HP to get the healing debuff.
Good luck getting him that low.
Can be very rough for this team. Sivir, not the best tank shredder. by any means.
No. What I actually liked a couple games ago was seeing Jarvan alongside Sivir, because the AoE armor shred from the Q of Jarvan actually really increased the Sivir damage output and actually allowed her to carry quite a bit harder, and that was pretty cool. That, of course, does not exist in this Team Impulse lineup, but there are ways to make Sivir your hard carry. I just don't know if this comp is really it.
Yeah, protect the Sivir with this is very rough. It's going to be a lot on Apollo's shoulders. The team fights that, and here's the thing too, right, is they have Keen. Keen can still get to Apollo, try to deal a lot of damage to him. They have that backline person. They also have the split push option available to them on Gravity's side, and then the disengage in the middle. Right now, he's just playing through laning phase and seeing who gets that tiniest of advantages and if they can spill it over.
Well, we gotta see. So far, the advantage is pretty small overall. A 500 gold lead. Team Impulse, as we mentioned, did play the lane swap a bit better, but it didn't manifest into too much more than just that. Bot lane turret is under a bit of pressure, but the cop bunny Fufu wave curse seems to be enough to not allow anything to really happen to it just yet. The waves crash into the turret, but they don't die. The turret, rather, doesn't die.
Apollo has a lot of pressure in this lane when you have the Sivir. Oh, they're trying to collapse on Saint. Trying to go on Saint here.
Says nearby, impact, then a 1v2, the early Ice Blast does break, it lands the stun. Saint ults too early! What a horrible misplay! That's gonna be first blood into impact, and now Hanser has gotta be afraid. He does have the ulti running, and his flash is available, but Rush!
That's a lot of
damage! Looking to burst him down, takes him out! Gravity severely misplay, and Team Impulse capitalized.
They're gonna be able to start pushing this top lane turret down, and freeing up impact to possibly roam around the map. They're gonna do a lot of damage to it, but look at that, Rush. Okay, he finally comes back for it.
I knew we knew better than that one.
Yeah.
So first turret of the game actually goes to Impact, who was set up for success at the very start of the game. Rush working well alongside him, and they make this play happen. The quick wave clear, the turret will go down.
Oh, they give him solo gold too.
Wow. Set Impact up to carry, why the heck not? 82 minions, 1-0-1. Merlin Amakon done whenever he recalls back.
Capitalizing off the misplay there of both Saint and Hanser. Really good ultimate. They saw this coming, they set up for it ahead of time. Impact Black shields himself so Snowball doesn't slow him, and then he sees the flash coming, keeps the tether range, and Saint pretty much just at that point trying to disengage, trying to make sure that Rush can't get in, and at least try to slow somebody. But man, that damage from Rek'Sai early on, that's where she shines, that early game.
And so far, so good. Nicely done. Saint Vicious on Nunu, supposed to be there for the vision control. The early Sightstone speaks to that, but we're unable to prevent the plays that happened here. The dual lane of Team Impulse versus Gravity. Kopp, the big driving, carrying force for the red team, is winning in minions by a little bit. Trinity Force should be in the next 2 to 3 minutes for him. And maybe he can make something happen here. But right now, the rest of the game is kind of all going Team Impulse.
Rush in this bottom lane. They're trying to shove out and just finish off this turret. Xiao Wei Xiao is wrapping around on the side.
Okay, Gravity, be careful. Don't stay for too long.
Here's
the roll. There's the dive on in. Comp's got nowhere to go. Valkyrie is on cooldown. Knockup is there. No reason to flash. He does it anyway. Oh my god, are you serious? The knockup comes in. They actually kept Comp alive. I cannot believe it. Gravity staying afloat, but turret still goes down.
So close to going down there. The Prey Seeker not making contact. Comp getting out just barely. And Bunny Fufu, the man behind it. Or in front of it, actually.
True. Team Impulse all the same off of a good fight and a good rotation. They were rewarded with the turret, as well as now this dragon. 12 and a half minutes in, they look for the first slay. They have now learned their first empowered shout.
Good coordination there. Xiao Wei Xiao shoves out mid, immediately roams faster than Keen can possibly clear the wave. And then, boom, Sivir ultimates popped. Everybody go as the turret goes down. Really good coordination on taking that turret out right as the team fight starts. You're gonna see it here. Apollo's like, oh, we exhausted Cop. He can't escape from this. Let's kill the turret. Boom, prank blade across. And he's almost dead. Jumps in front of it, blocks the auto from Bunny Fufu. And then Rush goes off to the side to try and get that last Prey Seeker, but nope.
You know, there's an interesting dynamic between you go for the champion first or the turret first. They had split focus a little bit. Cop was exhausted, but Apollo went to finish the turret. So it, in a way, tanked for him. Yeah, and he was able to flash out. I'm still surprised he lived. Just incredibly impressive by Gravity to get him out. You can't understate. Team Impulse made the right choice. Absolutely. They're growing a bigger and bigger lead this game.
Hindsight is 20/20. Of course.
What if you have short-term memory loss?
What did I say?
I don't know anymore. What game is this? Oh, man. Team Impulse or Gravity.
There you
go. I got it. We're good.
That's why we have it at the top, so Freak can remember during the game.
Thanks for the tip.
Oh,
he and those
got to
be real careful. Jumps across. Rush sees there's some wards. Kills the pink one. All right. 3,000 gold lead. Team Impulse looking to strangle this game out. Mid lane turret has stayed alive. Kopp was there as defense. And now the blue buff, the target for these guys.
Bullying a Nunu. They're trying to get this. I mean, there are no TPs available. This would be a 4-on-4. St. Vicious, though, is right
Nunu
there.
Nunu gets it. Wow. Great smite by St. Vicious. And now Rush
oh,
the
Tim,
wants revenge
back.
For this one. Nice ulti by Bunny Fubu separates the team, and Rush is still alone. In comes the backline dive from Keen, and they will pick off the Void Terror. And now Team Impulse realize they put off more than they can chew. Now they go.
Man, sometimes as a jungler, you just have to be okay with them getting the buff you were going for. Sometimes you're just like, he took it! I gotta get him! Gotta get my buff back! But no, definitely the wrong choice there.
All right, so Gravity showing some signs of life. And maybe they can stem the tide of this aggression. Team Impulse, though, still look happy to go in. They've got a cannon wave in front of this. Keen was forced to heal up that last fight, and they're going hard for this guy. Bunny could pop a breakable, but he will not pull any of the aggro. St. Vicious goes down! Wow, thanks to Impact.
It's not a support Morgana. Still does the same thing, though, when you land that binding.
Oh, my God, they landed two. They're looking for this one. Bunny Poo Poo finally does bring up the unbreakable to defend him. But a lot gained there. Apollo gets the blue buff.
A lot of that without Rush either. And Keen went to the right to go ahead and clear the bottom wave and shove that out. TIP just got to shove up the mid wave, get all three outer turrets for themselves over time. And they didn't really have to trade anything back for that. Impact having a really good performance on this Morgana early on.
Hard to 16 minions. I have to keep restating it. He was in a 1v2, a straight up 1v2 with no help and dominated minion kill wise, early cooldown build, tons of bindings, and life got miserable for Gravity.
I also like how he went for the green ward dropper very quickly too. It's 16 minutes into this game. Just hit level 10, you can't get that until you're 9. Immediately drops the 250 gold into that. So he can give his team that extra vision because he's going to stay top. He's going to continue to shove waves and wait and just ward up that side of the jungle, and then eventually they can capitalize on the amount of aggression that he's put on the map. Mm-hmm.
One thing I do want to, yeah, and he's doing great so far. But one thing I do want to track actually is how well he does against Dr. Mundo now. Yeah, okay, he's already got a lead. You expect him to succeed, but these sort of control mages never seem to do well against the tank tops, and slowly but surely they get pushed out because they just can't make the enemy champions budge. So I want to actually see the effect of the split pushing Morgana, and if anything gets done here.
He's eventually going to group up for things, though. He'll eventually start going very hard. He's getting his Zhonya's second item. And you can see it there. When he landed the binding, he's positioning himself to throw the Tormented Soil. And if it wasn't going to be enough, he would have just gone in. It looked like he wanted, as soon as the turret was done, to flash in and possibly throw his ultimate on people because they were all pumped. But instead, it's the pressure. It's keeping the Mundo here. He can interrupt TP, too. Mundo can't. So as long as he keeps tabs on Mundo, he'll be in a good spot.
True. So far, Haunter being held in the top lane means Team Impulse use their 4-on-4 advantage to run to the bottom lane and get their first Tier 2 turret of the game. Keep in mind, 17 minutes in, Gravity's only success so far has been a single kill, and that was Rush's over-aggression. So, not a lot of bright spots, unfortunately, happening for the red team here. Impulse looking among the best they have all year.
They immediately go towards the mid lane. Keen is on the right side. They do have vision of him from the TIP. Here comes Impact, just off on this left side, making sure. Cutting off the route from Mundo. shoving the wave up and looking for the bindings. That's what he's doing. He's looking for the bindings here so that they can get damage onto a key member. And then he just rotates. They out-rotate them. They're going to get this turret.
Well, Saint kind of goes a greedy way around. There's no real team to defend. Keeps getting CC'd. Forced to flash away, but the bind hits Cop. And in goes the team of Bramble to disengage. Saint fishes to buy some time as well. But Cop at 200 health means he's got to run away. A binding onto Hanser. He's healing as best he can. Bunny Fufu offloads some of the damage. But finally, the jump on into the back lines means a double kill for Xiao Wei Xiao. On top of that turret and gravity, cannot find defense.
Hanser is just not tanky enough at this point in the game. He's still a Mundo, but he's not that huge wall just yet. They're TIP, they get that tier 2, and they're going to crack the base in 18 minutes.
Wow, one of the fastest inhibitor turret kills I've seen all split long. 1847 for that turret destruction. And a binding out of key means they might kill Zed as well. And in fact, they do. Xiao Wei Xiao gets out with the black shield. Bunny Fufu now forced to run. Cop does have full health and escapes the binding.
These bindings from Impact are setting up his team immensely. You cannot understate the power that they are having right now.
And man, the tenacity by Team Impulse. This is,
I guess, overstated.
Yeah, but
you cannot overstate it.
You cannot.
Don't understate either. It's a lot.
Sure. It's a lot of states. But either way, Team Impulse, though, I have to admire their tenacity. Oh, got to run. Ulti popped by Ruck, put him nearby. And now, while they really want to chase, Cop is around. Saint Vicious lands a slow. Rush is going to tunnel away, but maybe a bit more slows will do what they need. Now Rush has got to be real careful. The Winner's Bite lands. The team's going to show up. Rush will be both of his team's casualties this game, but a fight ensues all the same. Impact will get a giant heal from the ulti. Apollo puts some damage back in, but they still take him down. In comes Adrian, flashes into fray. No ulti for him means he can get chased down, though.
Here comes Xiao Wei Xiao.
And that is Xiao Wei Xiao indeed. Saint Vicious now low on mana. Force run away. Great Winter's Bite, but will it be enough? A two-man Glitterlance. Haunter now wants to take these attacks. Apollo said thank you for the mana. The team's finally back out.
Rush, once again, over-aggression, not on the same page as his team. It's cost them two kills right now, the only kills that they've given up. But then Impact on top of it, becoming a straggler in that fight and continuing Rush's call.
Yeah, pretty big overstay there, a bit of over-aggression as well by this Impulse lineup. But they have managed to retain control afterwards thanks to their gold lead. And they even push in for ward coverage, even though they lost that fight. They're trying to play up. Which is maybe more than they should do.
Yeah, they're trying to get some control over the situation right now.
One thing I will say, though, we talk about it in champ select. The late game would be miserable if Hanser gets fed. Impulse are playing incredibly aggressively in the mid game where they are more powerful to try to push ahead and keep the game out of reach. 95% of the time, they've made the right choices here and continue to further their lead. They just can't slip up too many times.
A lot of that is looking at Rush right here. The times that we've seen them slip up this game from Impulse have been him going too hard, him not communicating that this is where he wants to go and that his team needs to back him up. And that last one, that was really him trying to defend and getting caught out.
Yeah. But we'll see if he can stem the tide a little bit here and look to pick himself up a victory in week 5 of the North American LCS. First turret of the game for Gravity might happen here. Hanser is being unopposed in the top lane. But he's giving so much respect to the fact that he has no vision control that he won't push in for it just yet. Impact might be able to defend. A red buff attempt here. Bunny Fufu blocks the Boomerang Blade. Rush in the wings. Will land this fight. In comes the red buff for him. Apollo does get slowed by Ice Blast.
Oh.
Pops the ulti, gets the team out.
Trying to disengage.
Good and safe. Sivir ult for red buff steal. I'm okay with that.
Yeah, they would really love Xiao Wei Xiao for these engages. Xiao Wei Xiao is actually 3,000 gold up over Keen at this moment.
Massive.
Yeah.
And now a blue buff.
Oh, yeah. The farm is real with Xiao Wei Xiao.
I do like his build, by the way. I really am a huge fan of Deathcap second on Lulu because she has offensive and defensive AP ratios. And, of course, you can't affect defensive abilities with things like Lich Bane procs or Magic Penetration. So just getting bigger shields, getting bigger ults, I think super worthwhile.
She also has utility AP ratios with the movement speed.
Is it still there?
I believe so. It just doesn't decay in the same way.
Yeah, you're right. It still has the AP ratio on the movement speed. I don't know why I thought that went away.
What went away was the fact that it would decay off of the ratio.
Oh, yeah, okay. The Q slow? Mm-hmm. Okay. That's what went down. Either way, still a lot of utility. Rush going to look maybe for a front line. He will get a two-man knock. A Bunny Poo Poo tanking the front lines. That means Rush could drop down. A big heal from Lulu keeps him afloat for now. But now Impact's got to be careful. Everyone flash away from the ulti. Forced to run away. Forced Azonia's Adrian resets the fight, and that means they can re-engage on a safe. Vision the Boomerang Blade takes him out from Apollo. And Keen only sitting and watching in the outskirts. Still has Deathmark. Has not used it on anyone.
That Impact has 100% kill participation right now on that Morgana. He's being a huge part of these fights, just zoning people off. Everybody's trying to get away from his soul shackles. He had multiple people locked up in that, but they all just got away from him and he got nothing, but it was still enough to zone the team off and allow his team to close that gap, close the vacuum, the space that they had left open in order to get this inhibitor. You can see it right here. He's gonna come in, boom, three people. Cop has to get rid of it, two flashes off to the sides, and then they get to spread the team out via that ultimate, and then Adrian to spread them out even further, and then it's the full disengage here, the full retreat, but St. Vicious goes down, and so does the inhibitor.
And there were a fair number of low health bars by Team Impulse, just not quite enough got done from Gravity. Again, I mentioned the fact that Keen had ulti and was not able to find a spot to use it. Could have maybe picked up one kill and made that fight look a little bit better. Team Impulse once again want to wrest control over this northern jungle. They are relentless in trying to take over. You can see many wards come down. They look to collapse around top lane tier 2. Gravity not in position to defend. Haunter in the bottom lane still recalling now. And there's a push in for the turret.
Yeah, Haunter out of position here, not able to reinforce this top lane turret. And a lot of Gravity have to deal with this mid lane. That's the thing, is they don't have enough numbers to allocate to this top lane. They have to keep them mid. Cop is still middle, trying to soak up this farm. They're trying to give him as much as they can here. So Keen is really their wave clear, where TIP, they have a ton of wave clear options. Lulu, Sivir, and also Morgana that has a bunch of AP, that's a huge wave clear tool.
Even Janna will buy you a little bit of time, knock the minions off, or even shield a turret if she were on defense. Here comes the push on in, top inhibitor turret, losing about a third of its health. Bunny Fufu with the shield keeps Cop alive. It's a good way to deal with Morgana binding, just block all the follow-up damage. Lulu immediately wave clears the back line.
I love me some Lulu wave clear. Takes me back. But yeah, Xiaowei is up 80 CS right now. They're funneling a lot of farm onto him when they group up. He's the one clearing the waves and getting that CS. Here's the thing though, is he is really effective against the Zed, so Keen is rendered almost useless in a dive.
The bind on the cop's gonna be blocked. The knock up there from Bunny Fufu. Impact sitting in the front lines. He knows he can take a couple of shots with Black Shield. And this turret is slowly getting worn down. Now mid lane right under the Nexus means someone's gotta defend that from Gravity. They send Cop and Haunter. But that is Mundo ulti down now.
Yeah, even though Rush got chunked out, he's just gonna come back with his Void Rush, so he's still a part of this engage. He's gonna come right onto the doorstep.
That's a bit aggressive.
Right into the turret, give him a warning shot.
Yeah, he's gonna be okay, I suppose. And I like that they've kept still impact with this lane to knock down the turret, to be part of the siege composition. Bunny Fufu does take the bind, actually, wow, gets exploded by Xiaowei Xiao. No defensive stats to speak of on that champion. And now inhibitor number 2 under fire. Will they take enough poke to push him off? Xiaowei Xiao himself is low. And there's the impact. Three-man Morgulthy diving on him. Pops the Zonia's Deathmark shouldn't do too much to him. And they're going to find a whole lot of cleanup. Two more kills picked up. Only two members of Gravity left alive as TIP limp away with just enough health to walk. And with a super minion wave in the mid lane, can they push for even more? So many low health bars makes me think this could be a risk, but they want the Nexus turrets. Number 1 under fire, Ice Blast onto Apollo. An Absolute Zero comes by as well, but the damage is just that. And Team Bubble forced to run away, but Rush does get a Winner's Bite on him. Takes his shield, still trying to run, but Rek'Sai is slowed by so much. He's getting hit up, and Rush with an Ignite will be taken down. Impact on the chase as well. A bunch of shields might keep him alive, but Adrian is now on the wrong side of this fight. And it is indeed an overstay by Team Impulse.
Adrian! No! But still, he goes down as a sacrificial lamb for the team, and now TIP getting those two inhibitors, that is huge for them. They started getting very over-aggressive on that Nexus turret. Very, very big overextension. Cost them two kills, but now they have a lot of margin for error. They have a lot of room to just make those types of mistakes, to be over-aggressive, to have Rush do what he was doing earlier. And now you can see Impact, he has a Magi's. He's ready to take more fights like this with his Zonias. Triple knockup into Soul Shackle. Cop immediately gets it off of him. And then there's still two members locked up. Apollo doing a ton of damage, and Xiaowei Xiao is way ahead of the item curve right now. He has so much gold on him. He is 70 CS up over his lane opponent. And to tell you about it, he's 4,000 gold higher than Keen. That is a huge amount of AP onto him, a huge amount of gold that is going to shut down Keen.
Yeah.
So much HP from his Wild Growth, so much damage from his Glitter Lance. When Alulu's in that situation, she's clearing waves remarkably quick, and she is chunking champions out that you wouldn't expect. And
yeah.
Mundo is still not at the point where he can deal with this. He is a late-game AP soaker.
Exactly. This reminds me of actually, hold on a second, Rush going in right away for Haunter. Pops the ult. Adrian wants in. It's a bit of a slow, but it's just way clear. It reminds me of CLG's win yesterday, where they had this early game siege composition focused on Tristana, and they were relentless and picked up so many advantages, there was no comeback. Same thing here, Xiao Wei, Xiao, and Impact, despite the fact that they shouldn't have a good late game, are too far ahead to care. There's a jump on in, they bind Saint Vicious. He's forced to run away, pops absolute zero. Adrian takes a fair bit of damage as well, but I still have not seen Keen enter the fight. Impact does lock the team down. One kill picked up, the jungler's gone. Buddy Fufu will stay alive just barely, but now Nexus turret number one is under fire, and it goes down. Number two, also the target of attack. Keen forced to run away, Buddy Fufu already dead. Rush on the wings, setting up the kill on a Haunter. That's gonna happen as well. A double kill for Xiao Wei Xiao, and Team Impulse finally find themselves a controlled game with a lot of good plays. And a 29-minute win over Gravity.
Impact, 2-1-12, 100% kill participation on Morgana. He forces Cop to get a QSS second item because he's just going so hard on him every fight. There was so much pressure from TIP, they didn't let up, and Xiao Wei Xiao also had an incredible game, and he's looking more like the farm champion that we knew him to be last season.
Yeah, there was no pressure on him at all from Saint Vicious in the mid lane. That Nunu was kept track of all game, and you got to see Xiao Wei Xiao play a 1v1, go do aggressive things. The player we expected to see all year, the player we saw in late 2014, Xiao Wei Xiao showed us why he earned that MVP title in the summer split just a few months ago. And everyone else, as you mentioned, showing up well. Impact, 100% kill participation. Apollo and Adrian, the North American bot lane, did quite well overall against Cop and Bunny Fufu. I gotta say, that was an impressive game from Team Impulse.
They didn't let Cop get off the ground, and they played it fast. They didn't let the pressure up, because this is a team that may struggle in the late game when you get even on items, or when this Mundo gets very tanky. So TIP put their foot on the gas, and they didn't stop. That puts both these teams at 5-5.
Yeah.
But TIP are 2-0 over Gravity in the tiebreaker.
Puts them higher up in the standings, of course. There is still an incredibly tight race in the middle all the same. 8 games to go, top 6 make playoffs, and you still got 5 teams all clustered around right near the middle mark here. And these next few weeks will really tell you who's gonna make playoffs, who's gonna face challenger teams in the promotion tournament. And who sits there twiddling their thumbs in 7th place doing nothing? But that's going to be one of these guys.
7th place gets a really nice vacation. They're just like, we don't even go to playoffs. We don't get anything. But you also don't get points.
Yeah, you don't get points. You don't get demoted at the very least. But it means you just kind of sit there and hope that you do better in the summer. Yeah. Team Impulse, we knew it was going to be a building split for them. And to be honest, their build has been slower than most of these teams. Winter Fox generally seemed like they were hitting their strides sooner. This is the first I've seen Team Impulse say, okay, this looks like a really good team. If this is the kind of game they play, I have high, high hopes for these guys. We'll see if it happens throughout the split, but for now, we're going to send it down to Riv on the stage, joined by Impulse's